Good afternoon, everybody. We begin with the next session. This session is on social entrepreneurship. Why, how, and the need and support for social entrepreneurship. May I invite Mr. Pradeep Bhargava, Director Cummins, on stage. Mr. Pradeep Bhargava is the Director Cummins India Limited, Pune, past chair, CII Western Zone. He's worked for the Government of India in the Atomic Energy Commission, ISRO, and has been a consultant to UNDP and World Bank. His business leadership role in consumer and industrial sector has been very prominent. He is active in various industry forums. He's engaged in various agenda of civic society like skill, employability, and women empowerment. He's associated with leading academic institutions. We welcome Mr. Pradeep Bhargava, the chair of this session. Please give him a round of applause. May I invite Mr. Rajiv Kher, CEO and founder, Sara Plast Private Limited. His passion for better sanitization led him to create India's very first portable sanitation and liquid waste management company way back in 1999. He is awarded as Impact Entrepreneur of the Year by the Global Steering Group in Chicago recently. He is one of the India's top 50 social impact entrepreneurs who are making a difference to the lives of people in India. He served as the only Asian member on the board of directors of the Portable Sanitation Association International US from 2010 to 2013. We welcome Mr. Rajiv Kher. I would like to invite Mr. Amol Shafikar. He's MD Strata Group, Strata Enviro Private Limited. He is a managing director who invests in select disruptive patented technology products and supports to boost the global sales of its portfolio companies exponentially through a very unique and credible network of business partners across the globe. And Mr. Prashant Girbane. Yes, don't look around. I'm not introducing him again because he's already been introduced twice since yesterday. He needs no introduction. Welcome to Prashant Girbane, Honorary Director of PIC. Oh, sorry, Mr. Pradeep Lokhande, please come on stage. Mr. Pradeep is a founder of CEO of Rural Relations, a social entrepreneur who has worked in over 41,000 villages in Maharashtra. I welcome all the panelists. May I request Dr. Anand Sardeshmukh to kindly welcome our guests.
I've already got one.
Good afternoon. Prashant was asking me a little while ago, what have we done to deserve this slot after lunch? And then we were debating whether there'll be more people on the dais or off the dais. So we're sort of okay because Prakash came in things. Now, the good part is that we are almost at the end of the limited over tournament of 2 days. All of you are waiting for the finale, the last few overs of the valedictory. So I think we'll just make our job so much easier. You know, I have gone through this, and I really want to once again seriously compliment Chamber, Anant, you, Manjari, for putting together a very comprehensive, diverse set of things, but all the things that's required in the skill space. And I'm saying this as a preamble because this was one slot or one aspect which we thought we'd cover about the social. So it's been very interesting. And of course, when you manage such programs, you have to also manage the skill of some people backing out at the last minute of, you know, how to rejig the programs, and that's part of the things. So the way we want to go about doing this is we have 60 minutes. Promise we will do within 60 minutes. Yeah.
Already?
Yeah, okay. You know, I'll always put the question answers in the end. So after that, it's not up to us, depending on how many questions come, so we can do it. So first 5 to 7 minutes, I'll do context setting, And you know, since I'm the least skilled amongst this group, I can only do is setting skills, setting context, because beyond that I don't know, and all these wise men will be able to do. Then I'm going to ask these four pundits to opine on the subject without any biases, without what do they think about the subject as given to them, because I know very little, these people know a lot. So they'll give their thing, of course I'll take the liberty of putting a poser. So that's going to be the second in which you spend about 30 minutes. Thereafter, and since Prashant, you said after lunch, I want panelists also to be staying awake. So I'm going to get the next 10 minutes. I want each panelist to opine on, comment on what some other panelist has said. So they need to be alert, not only in what they're discovering. So they're going to say whether they agree, disagree, whatever they want to do. So they're just going to react. But that's the best way of getting an interaction, because in 1 hour, you can't do everything. And finally, of course, there'll be question answers from all of you. This is how I want to do. As far as my part is concerned, I don't have anything. I just have a couple of caveats, three or four myths which I want to opine on, and then of course we'll carry on with the things. The caveat is the why and how of social entrepreneurship. I'm going to leave it to you guys. You just do need and supply. I'm going to only talk about by whom and when. And I think it's important to understand, and that's a limited thing. The second one, I don't want any one of us to believe that when we say social entrepreneurship, there's no arrogance here. There is no sense. We are not trying to say that everything else is antisocial. You know, what you guys discussed for the 1.5 days, certainly adding to the society, is nothing antisocial about it. But what we are trying to bring out here, that there is an element, there is an aspect which needs to be considered. Whenever we're doing entrepreneurship, of course, all of us start with the basic payback period, returns, banks, you know, there is a whole financial, which is fine, that's correct, but there has got to be a reminder, it is complementary, it's integral part. So I think this is the only caveat I want to put, that social isn't something that takes a high moral ground. No, I think there's nothing social left if there is no economics. So I just want us to be sure that we're not being arrogant about it. The four myths. The first myth, and I think all of us are guilty of it, somehow we believe that if I elect a government and pay my taxes, I have abdicated my responsibility towards society and towards the environment. Sarkar hai na, wo BPO samajhte hai usko. We outsource all the responsibility to do with society and with environment to the government, because you know what, I'm paying my taxes. So it's not my responsibility. Somehow it's one of the most escapist, irresponsible stand that most of us in the society take, including corporates, where this is not my job. It's not my job to take care of the society, societal issues, it's not my job to do. I think that's dumb. I think that's more irresponsible. I think each one of us, every element of the member of the society need to understand it's not Sarkar which will do it. Sarkar will facilitate, Sarkar will take the lead. But social responsibility is ours. The second aspect, we also somehow start believing that anything which has got social overtones by definition is deficit. By definition it requires subsidy. By definition it's not viable, it's not sustainable. Somehow this belief that, and that's one of the ways we justify not getting into it. Arey, usme to loss hoga, usko kaise karenge, usme to dhanda nahi hai, paisa nahi hai. We pretend that everything that is social, and there are multiple models where social entrepreneurship, social innovation, social businesses have been profitable, viable. Let's not use the word profitable, but viable, sustainable. So this belief that only a non-social activity is economically viable and social activity, that's second myth we want to do. Third, we again, that's another myth we want to do, that social is related only to socially deprived and economically challenged people. You know, we do social means kisi ka bhala kar rahe hain, kiska bhala kar rahe hain, jo gareeb hai, surakshit hai, you know, somehow. That's not true. If you were to take up, and think of instances, if you were to take up something against health, something against, you know, smoking, something against drugs, those are social challenges. They don't distinguish between rich and poor. They affect each one of us. So if you were to pick up certain agenda which addresses basic issues, it's not necessarily aimed at economically challenged and socially deprived. So I think, and lastly, and I think this is true for most of us, I see are from corporates, not so many things. Socially responsible business is something that we need to acknowledge. It's not like an add-on that I'll make a cake I want, but I'll put icing because it looks like this. Whole lot of us, I mean, there are a lot of you from organizations which are corporates. Do we think quality is the responsibility of only the quality department? Quality is the responsibility of everybody. Similarly, having socially responsible conduct is not the responsibility of CSR department. Each one of us in our conduct need to be socially responsible, socially responsible business. So why am I giving all this stuff? Because social entrepreneurship should not be perceived as an add-on or for some sector, for some NGO, for some corporates as part of CSR, That's what I will do, but my business can be what I want to do. I think they need to be integrated. When Hindustan, I keep giving this instance, when Hindustan Levers makes a shampoo which requires no water, or if they make a detergent which requires much less of water, I think they're being socially responsible. That they will make money is different, but they're going to do a huge conservation of water. You know, those are the types of things. And you know, social responsibility, social, I'm not saying CSR, social entrepreneurship, social innovations are not necessarily oriented towards add-on, but they are part of the global picture. And that's the prime one wanted to make. For example, I just closed my part of the thing by giving this instance where a whole lot of us in Pune, many years ago, this the load shedding that CII was involved and I was involved into it. What was it all about? It was using the meeting the needs of the society, and we distinguish between higher strata, lower strata, everybody in the city of Pune. We utilize the capacity that is available in the corporate sector, and we did it in a manner which is financially viable, no subsidy economically. That was a social entrepreneurship, social innovation. And it did not involve making something for the poor or something. So social innovations can be there across. With this backdrop, now may I come to the speakers. I'll start with you, Rajiv. I know your profile is there. You've been a bit of a, not bit, pretty much of a missionary, providing sanitation to the unserved people, social business. And we always thought either you do social or you do business, but yours is social business, which is amazingly interesting, you think, acknowledged. So my, go ahead and talk on this subject. My only question to you, and I've seen your background, were you ever distracted by the glamour associated with your peers in what they were doing versus what you're doing? I'm saying this because I graduated from Ahmedabad and decided to work for Bharat Sarkar for 10 years. And a lot of my colleagues would say, what's wrong with you? Well, what are you doing with the government? And my colleagues were with Levers and TAS, okay? But you know, and you did something more. But the point is, this whole aspect.
Sorry to interrupt. I think he just wouldn't want to add that he was also the class topper of IIM Ahmedabad of that batch.
Now, the issue, I think, tell us, as part of your delivery, as to what kept you into this. You didn't get distracted by people selling chiclets and chocolates, you know, which a lot of people are doing. Go ahead, Rajiv.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
So I address your question first before I talk about blow my own trumpet. I remember when I had a job in North America, which I quit to come back to start this sanitation business. And a lot of people laughed at me. In fact, very close relative of mine, who I don't want to name, but also asked me, you know, if you're going to work with toilets and sanitation, tujhashi lagna kon karnar? So that was also, you know, because this space was not really, it's, in India, I mean, in general, sanitation and working with toilets, talking about toilets is quite a stigma. And I believe that even when we're a lot younger, and you're sitting on a dining table and you start talking about toilet and shit and whatever, the elder person in the house will tell you, okay, listen, don't talk about it on the dining table. They talk shit all the time. So, and talking about the glamour side of things, the reason for, I always thought that, yes, this is not a glamorous business, but looking at the way I dress, probably, I look like I'm not in the IT, but the SHIT industry, which I like to say with a lot of pride. And I think it's important to also understand that I take a lot of pride in the work that I do. And when I decided to do this, I had two choices. I think this used to be a very typical situation when most people in, used to travel to India, and the moment they got down at Bombay, everybody was complaining in the plane that, oh, it's smelling so bad and it's so nice over there. And so I had two choices in front of me. Either I continue to complain about this problem and carry on, join the bandwagon. The other option was to do something about it. I decided to roll up my sleeves and decided to do something about it and change the way that the perception of the country changes. And until 2013, when the Prime Minister at the Red Fort gave Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. I mean, that was pretty much a dream come true for us. So definitely, this whole evolution of getting into this business, creating an impact, also developing a profitable business model, which today we have private equity investors that have invested in the company. We've scaled substantially. We're in about 8 states in India. I have a Swiss investor, I've got an Indian impact investor, and we're now doing our Series C funding. So as a company, we're growing. We do a positive EBITDA about 18 to 20%. So we're growing rapidly, and it's a space which is very interesting. If you leave the, you know, if you can think about it, it's something which you can't do without. You have to deal with waste. And it's something that, the future is not just toilets and cleaning toilets, but it's also about generating energy out of it, creating a renewable resource out of the waste. So innovation is extremely crucial to this. And I don't look at it as a pure job, it's more of a passion for me. But it's also impactful, and I generate a lot of profit as well. So that's really my take on that.
Okay. Could I come to you, Amol, now?
Yes.
Yours is, of course, you're calling yourself a serial entrepreneur. Obviously, you have to be serial entrepreneur because your job is to do disruptive things. So when you disrupt one, you have to move to the next one because you disrupted that one. Nah? In fact, you're also a parallel entrepreneur because I believe you do multiple things, which is interesting. And you're one person who I noticed from your profile who's both into brick and click. You do SPMs and you also do artificial intelligence, which is a rare combination. People define themselves as one of those two. So thanks so much for this. Just tell us when the social aspect of business that you've been doing and you through Rotary and otherwise, you're so tuned to paybacks and so tuned to returns, so tuned to this. How do you change your frequency when you come to a situation like this? Because that's a question a lot of people don't. Not that I'm saying there's no payback. There is a social payback. There is a financial payback. Tell us that as well, your thoughts on this complete story on social entrepreneurship.
I'll take the last word over here. When we talk about social entrepreneurship, the first word should be replaced as entrepreneurship. Going back to, let's say, 20-30 years of back, we had only one field, like engineering field. There was mechanical, chemical, and electrical. And then it started dividing into focus area. Similarly with entrepreneurship, we say, I'm an entrepreneur, but my focus of some of my ventures is related to social. If you're talking about what is social and what is to be done. So if you talk about 20-30 years back again, we talk about roti, kapda, makan is what is the basic necessity out there. So what we found is we need to retune ourselves about the basic necessities which are today's time. So roti, kapda, makan is not today's day. What we have is something, we need pure air, fresh air. We need pure and fresh water. Water is a scarcity around here. And we need energy. So we have aligned ourselves into the new needs out here, which are water, air, and energy. So that's what our company does. Now what social do is, let's say one of our company which installs outdoor air purification systems, and we do it for free. And when people ask me, how do you do it for free? There's a basic question. You're a social entrepreneur. You're installing free pollution controllers in our premises, no cost taken, capital cost borne by us, maintenance cost borne by us. How do you make money? That's a common question which is there. So what happens is that there are two types of entrepreneurs, which is you take money from someone and then you give back to the society. The second thing is you build an ecosystem in such a way that the system runs on its own. So what we have tried to do in here is we have built an ecosystem. Now not only in India, but we have in other countries as well where, let's say we are in Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand and other places also. So we are also changing not only the Indian part and other part also. Let's say, are we profitable? Yes, we are very much profitable. We have invested a capital amount by ourselves and we are backed by somewhere around 250 crores is what I can say very strongly. And investors would not put in 250 crores in us if they don't see profit. Whatever I say is social is okay, but are we going to make money out of it? So I'm trying to build a system in which people earn out of it and still going to pay back to the society. That's what we do. So probably these are some of the things. Talking about support, which is one more agenda in here. We never believed in relying on support. The more you seek support, you start falling weak. So what we started is we started building our own systems. Don't wait for the support part of it. It becomes, you start kind of lean on it. So that's what we are doing. Regarding the other companies, what we do is that we build, operate, and then we hand it over to someone who's a cost center and take it ahead. So that's what precisely we do. Thank you.
You know, this is very fascinating and interesting. You talked about payback, but you also used the word payback to the society. Now, this is a debt we never talk about. We are very happy to take from the society. We are happy to pollute the environment. We are happy to to a traffic jam as corporates, and don't even believe that we have an obligation to the society, and I think it's a payback. But I think irrespective of that, you also talked about the real payback in financial terms that comes through by innovative mechanisms of this. Thank you so much, and I think it's interesting that you brought a flavor to the entire business conduct, which is socially responsible business. You're doing things in a very manner. Now let's change the flavor to my wonderful friend Pradeep. Now, Gyan Ki Libraries is what you do. NRE samajhte the, NRV ho gaya, NRE to hum samajhte, NRI samajhte, NRV, which is amazing, 3,200. So like, certainly talk about your perspective, but I just want to tell you something. One of the reasons I have great respect for you, in corporate life, to manage situation is very easy. You have somebody reporting to you, he or she will listen to you. You are, he or she is accountable to you, you can control the business, so you say ye karo, wo karo, and they do it. Aapke charm aur passion ke alawa, aur kya mantra hai, jisse you are able to go across to these people, motivate them, get them to do things. None of them are obliged to you, but still aap unse itna kuch karwa sakte hai, uska jara sa bhi gyan dijiyega. You know, how are you able to motivate such people to do what you've been doing, and of course your thoughts on this social entrepreneurship? Yeah. Yes, Pradeep.
हमारे देश में पहले क्या है, सोशल शब्द जब आता है तो वी थिंक दैट गरीब आदमी के लिए कोई आप करने के लिए निकल चुके हो और खुद को इतना बड़ा समझने लगते हो कि काम होता ही नहीं है. दैट इज द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम. अनदर परसेप्शन ऑफ अर्बन इंडिया इज आई एम पेइंग ह्यूज टैक्स एज यू मेंशन वेरी करेक्टली एंड ऑल बेनिफिट इज गोइंग टू द लास्ट माइल देयर एंड दैट इज रूरल इंडिया. ही थिंक्स दैट यू आर एंजॉइंग the light, power, education, and everything, we are not getting anything. यहाँ होर्डिंग है जहाँ 2400 घंटे लाइट चलती है और वहाँ घर है जहाँ छोटा बच्चा एजुकेशन लेता है, वहाँ उसको 18 घंटे का लोड शेडिंग है. Who is responsible? Every time we blame the government. दसों के दस उंगलियाँ. So हमें देखना पड़ेगा, unless and until we'll not take this rule India to along with us, हम इस देश को जो सुपर पावर वगैरह रॉन्ग शब्द यूज कर रहे हैं उसको बंद करना पड़ेगा, बिकॉज इट इज आर्टिफिशियल स्वेलिंग एंड इट इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ एवरीबडी, फ्रेंकली स्पीकिंग, एंड एवरीबडी इज डूइंग इट ऑल्सो. ओनली सर द प्रॉब्लम इज कलेक्टिव विजडम. लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर डूइंग लॉट ऑफ गुड वर्क अक्रॉस द कंट्री. हम भी कर रहे हैं, आप भी कर रहे हैं, सभी लोग कर रहे हैं. थोड़ा सा कलेक्टिव विजडम होना चाहिए और पीपल शुड स्टार्ट रिस्पेक्टिंग दैट. क्योंकि द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन एवरीबडी आस्क मी इज पैसे कुटने था, आप इतना अच्छा शर्ट कैसे पहनते हो, ये तो चोरी नहीं कर सकता हूं ना मैं, तो ये तो इसके पैसे आते ही है कहीं से. सो दैट्स व्हाई वी आर अ सोशल एंटरप्रेन्योर, वी आर डूइंग अ सोशल वर्क एंड एज एन एंटरप्रेन्योर वी आर अर्निंग मनी. यस देर आर इथिक्स टू इट कि वी डोंट गो एंड प्रोपोगेट द लिकर एंड टोबैको बेस प्रोडक्ट्स. यस वी फॉलो दैट और वी डोंट सेल एनीथिंग बिकॉज वी आर इन अ रिलेशनशिप बेस्ड business. Gyan Ki is, believe me, there are a lot of wonderful people, good people in this world. I am a celebrity nor I am a film star nor, because itne logon ko hum respect karte hain aur kisi ko karte nahi hai. In spite of that, every day we are opening 3 libraries, means there are a lot of people across the world who believe in good work and they support you. But the only one word that is very important is हम उसमें कितना ट्रांसपेरेंसी रखते हैं. वही सबसे बड़ी इस देश की परेशानी है, क्योंकि कुछ ना कुछ इसमें काला है. वो हमेशा सोचते अगर इफ यू उसका अच्छे से आंसर देते हो देर इज नो लुक बैक, एंड वी हैव डन दैट. वी हैव डन दैट बिकॉज इन 1390 डेज वी हैव ऑलरेडी ओपन 3640 लाइब्रेरी. यू हैव आस्क्ड मी, दैट्स व्हाट आई एम टेलिंग यू. एंड वी रीच टू 10 लाख स्टूडेंट्स, एंड इट इज नॉट नेक्स्ट टू पुणे. You take any taluka of Maharashtra, any taluka, I am not talking of district, there are minimum 6 to 10 libraries and they are in 2 to 8,000 pop strata village, means a small building of a Pune, 350 households. So it happens, you start believing people, people start believing you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. You bringing up absolutely a wonderful perspective ki jahan where there's a will, there's a way, and you have found the way. And thank you so much for brought out to and our perspective on, you know, these are offbeat entrepreneurs like you. गांव में जाके लोगों को ज्ञान देने की सुविधा देना is something which most people will not, they'll say let's ramp up the primary education, let's look at AICTE, let's look at you know central board of education, you know badi badi baatein hoti hain par aap ek grassroot ticket
hai
is bare mein aur aap think collectively karne ke bare mein. Now my last colleague is you know it's very difficult to describe. I've been telling Prashant defies definition and I don't need to define him. All that I wanted to mention Prashant when you're going to be talking, first of all he's one guy whose bandwidth is very large, and you know all of us understand physics, all of us understand transfer through conduction, convection and radiation. These are three ways in which heat gets transferred. This guy has the opportunity of not only conduction, convection, and most of us get through radiation. He has been, has his role in PIC and as otherwise, he has touched so many people's in their lives and experience that today you're a repository of not only a lot of knowledge, but you're a repository of a fairly wide bandwidth of knowledge. So Prashant, it's a pleasure to have you here. Your thoughts on this, because I'm also aware, I've had the opportunity of interacting with both of you when we're doing the social innovation stuff. Give us your thoughts on social entrepreneurship and maybe element of social innovation that you think, and then we'll get on. Yeah.
Hello. Hi. Thank you, sir. It's always an honor sitting in your panel and with all of them here. I think I'm not a practicing social entrepreneur, but there is something that we do at Pune International Center. So I'll just kind of tell you a tad bit about it, if that's okay. So Pune International Center is a think tank in Pune. Dr. Raghunath Mashalkar is the president. Dr. Vijay Kelkar is vice president. On the website, you will get a whole lot more detail. I'll not give the whole PPT of it. You know. And of course, Maratha Chamber is also an institutional member of PIC and very well associated with it. And we do a lot of things together. PIC organizes many programs, lectures, roundtables, policy papers. There's one very, very important element of Pune International Center, and that is social innovation domain. It organizes a national conference on social innovation every year. And no surprises for guessing, the pillars on whom the NCSI stands is Mr. Pradeep Bhargava, Mr. Pradeep Lokhande, and there are some others here. And of course, Rajiv made a presentation a couple of years ago.
First one.
Also, when we came up with the policy paper on sanitation, Rajiv wrote much of it. Late Dr. Dilip Padgaonkar wrote a whole lot of it, and they presented it to the relevant minister. So I'll just mention the fact that if any one of you are interested in the space of social innovation, if you find out the portal, Pune International Center portal, you would find the relevant contact details there, both mobile number and email address. You could call them and you could drop in at any point in time and get associated with it. You know, that's one. Second, interestingly, we received a communication from the central ministry. They are forming a policy on social enterprise. What social enterprise is and how it should work and rest of it. So Delhi ministry people, including Honorable Secretary, are coming to Pune to listen to Punekers on how the policy should be shaped. So we are providing a platform for that on how to define social enterprise policy. Thank you. Oh yes, even if I'm not chairing the session, there are no penalty for clapping, that I can assure you, whenever you feel like. You know. So, I think 19th August this is happening. There is also a social innovation forum where likes of Anshu Gupta of Goonj, Ms. Pradeep Lokhande and others have come and talked about their story and what they're doing. So I'm more like a station manager. Gaadi mein koi nahi chala raha hoon, but a station manager hai. Station is a platform for doing social innovations. कई सारी अच्छी अच्छी गाड़ियाँ आती हैं, दैट इज द स्पीकर्स. कई सारे पैसेंजर्स आते हैं, विच इज द ऑडियंस, एंड एवरीवन हैज अ गुड टाइम. सो इट्स गुड फन मैनेजिंग द स्टेशन सर. थैंक यू.
या बट ये हमेशा हरी झंडी दिखाते हैं. यू नो देयर आर लॉट ऑफ स्टेशन मैनेजर्स जो गाड़ियों को रोक देते हैं, क्लैश करा देते हैं. यू कीप द ट्रैक गोइंग एंड द नंबर ऑफ ट्रैक्स दैट आर देयर इन योर स्टेशन इज माइंड बॉगलिंग. एंड ही इज राइट. एक्चुअली द जॉय एंड द किक दैट यू गेट आउट ऑफ अ सोशल innovation, social entrepreneurship cannot be monetized. You can translate, but wo alag hi nasha hai, wo alag hi josh hai, wo alag hi khushi hai. And I think we all need to acknowledge it and you to experience it with this. So now with this session over, before I go to the audience, I'm going to ask each one of you to opine on, comment, elaborate, disagree with, whatever it is. Quickly, Rajiv, let's start with you. You choose anyone.
Yeah, so I think Amol mentioned about sustainability. I think when we talk about impact, when I say impact, it's social impact, there has to be an element of profitability. And until you have an element of profitability, you cannot be sustainable. That's for sure. So again, profit is not a bad word. The other part is that if you really want to grow, scale, and reach out to people, then there must be an element of scale. And therefore, I believe that there has to be a clear business model to generating revenue, generating profit, generating employment, which overall creates the impact that we're looking for. So it's not just the impact in the space that you're working, but also a force that you're working within, which is trying to create that that impact. And sustainability being the key word, I believe you know, many of the NGOs and many of the have a challenge that getting funds and grants is difficult. So you know, normally you have a project which would be funded for a certain period of time, and then unfortunately after that period is over, the project sort of you know, diminishes, or many of the times even loses its momentum. But in impact businesses that we create, for example, I work in the sanitation space, so providing toilets to rural and urban India, creating a business model from toilets, which is quite unheard of really in the past. So we were pioneers in creating a business model for toilets. We started with portable toilets, created a revolution with that. And now we provide like thousands and thousands of toilets to Pandharpur, Alandi, Kumbh Mela, and it's a phenomenal money generation model. Not only do we employ a lot of people, but the kind of impact. So for example, every year along with our board meeting, we have at the annual general meeting, we have an impact assessment that we do. So in, for example, this year, we reached out to 22 million users in the entire year. So 22 million users used toilets in India. In addition to that, we collected something like 155 or 235 million liters of waste, which could probably have gone into the rivers, into canals, into dams, into ponds, affecting the environment substantially. So, and health. So we realized that the places where we work in, for example, let's say Pandharpur or Alandi or Kumbh Mela, the primary health center gave reports that this year 60% of the total illnesses were reduced by 60% at the primary health care center. Cases like diarrhea have reduced because of better sanitation. So, you know, look at the impact that it creates. So at a board meeting, we also have an impact assessment that we do. So I do agree that sustainability and that leading to profit will create this much desired change that we're looking at creating.
Yeah. I think the point brought out very well, there's nothing vulgar about profit. In fact, profit is the only key to sustainability. There can be vulgarity in achieving those profits. That's a different story. But the fact that even social agenda needs sustainability, and I think you bring it out very well. Thank you so much. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I think I could just reflect on what Rajiv was mentioning and his business model, right? It's very interesting how we miss spotting such opportunities. It's almost envious, Rajiv, in what you've done. Because it's way a lot easier to look at how do I start one more food technology company, food delivery company, like the Swiggy and Food Panda and rest of it. There were 119 of those that came up in 18 months, by the way. 119 of those came up in 18 months. In 2015, almost anyone and everyone that I knew in my corner, you know, in the society, told me how they are going to start an e-commerce company that delivers grocery at home. Almost everyone. So it's very funny that everyone wants to be the millionth guy in the race rather than be the first guy in trying to do something like Mr. Lokhande, who's been, you know, the first one in what he's done. Or like Rajiv for that matter. So the bottom up pyramid being so much of a wealth, right, somehow we can't spot it. And it reminds me of what Dr. Mashalkar mentions quite a few times. It's like doing good while you're doing well. You're doing well, for sure you must do well to sustain, which is wealth and health and everything. But you're also doing good, and good to the society, right? I think that's what I'll mention. Just to add last point, we're listening to Ramesh Raskar at PIC. So Ramesh Raskar is from Nasik, studied in College of Engineering Pune, studied in MIT in Boston, teaches in MIT, and got some Nobel equivalent awards in mathematics. you know, his whole focus is on telling a whole lot of people in India and abroad that there's a huge wealth at bottom of pyramid if you are able to bring innovative solutions to it, which will deliver both the money to you, accolades to you, and Rajiv didn't mention one of the international awards he received just recently in Chicago? In Chicago. And all of that, not just for you, but for the country. So all of that is there if you do that, and that's the point.
Absolutely. I think we have these two instances, Rajiv.
Can I add one quick point? So, you know, a lot of people...
So a lot of people say that, you know, the best ideas, the best thoughts come while you're sitting on the pot, right? But nobody looks at the pot itself. I think I happened to do that. And that's what actually innovation was.
No, but I think it's really commendable. We are privileged to have you and Pradeep, who have picked up what is called an offbeat item. But as Prashant said, they're looking at you, staring at you, and there's an opportunity. And you talked about, and both of you talked about scalability. If you make your model simple, if you make it replicable, scalable, these are the areas where you can have multiple things, and you'll be earning, if not only money, but blessings. And I think blessings are as important in life as money is, and I think all of us learned it on the way. Pradeep ji, boliye.
Yeah. My say is like this, sir. 67 years back, we used to say, go to villages. And even today, the buzzword is go to villages. 55% people stay in rural India. Just you take a laptop and think of only urban India and the world population. In spite of that, if you think something good about the rural India, huge opportunities. Huge opportunities. We are not looking at it. He has done it. I am doing it. He is doing it. It should be for the masses. What is happening is we are after money. I know that everybody should be, and I am not against that. But a lot of opportunities there. Previously, there was a lot of issues, but India changed after 1993. The importance of education, the communication has reached, they have some money. Now they want value for money. So there are a lot of opportunity to do a lot of good activities in education, health, and definitely in sanitation. Lot of opportunities. Please do it. Please do it.
Thank you so much, Pradeep. Thanks so much. Amol, your thoughts.
I'll add up to what Mr. Pradeep said is about more lives. When we're touching more lives, let's go 200 years back. I mean, I'm going back to and fro, but let's say 200 years back, there are rich people and there are people who have impacted lives. We remember those who have impacted life more than those who were rich. Because the more lives you touch, your presence in this world after you leave is there. So that's what is one thing which is there. And secondly, about transparency and fundraising, that's a very key role. Because let's say, talk about a big man, Mr. Dhirubhai Ambani. But he created transparency and wealth for all the stakeholders. So he never faced a problem of fundraising across. There's a sufficient amount of transparency and there's a sufficient amount of stake for all the stakeholders. So anytime something, the phone comes in and there are people who are ready to fund it. So creating something which is transparent enough as he has done and putting it across to people fund is not a problem for a social entrepreneur in any way. Thank you.
Guys, we have tried to sell social entrepreneurship, innovation, not as a replacement of, but as a supplement to, complementary to what you're doing. And I think this is very, very important for us. The skill sets required, perhaps if I could say, look at the mindset of these people, much more than the skill set. Their perspective, unki dharna kya hai, unke sanskar kya hai. You know, this is what is Rajiv going to drive it. It's just not skill and ability to do, because you said fundraising can be done. But it's the mindset which is very important. And I think for social entrepreneurship, mindset is more important than skill set to start with. And then, of course, you get onto this. So we're pretty much on time. And now we have questions. Again, just come to you, ma'am. We would want you to address it to who the person you want to. Moderator's job is only to moderate. He's not any one of the speakers. So go ahead and. Yes, ma'am.
I hope Mr. Kheer is being married now. And his job is not okay.
He got very good dowry also.
Whenever it's always a business or money or market exploitation, then only the companies talk about a particular market. It happened with bottom of pyramid. It is happening for rural marketing, because the companies find good opportunities, good market and returns after on their investment. So I hope social entrepreneurship and social enterprise is the only area where we can build our own nation. So I just wanted to know what are the challenges you face. Like, are we not just migrating, are we not just making the rural India as an in a new phase of urban India? Like,
I call it as a tomorrow's India. Now rural India is not a rural India, it is tomorrow's India. Please. Marathi sanga, sanga.
Yeah, because I'm just finding short of words for to explain my concept.
Sanga, Marathi zarat asel sanga.
Gramin Bharatala shahari karana, tacha karana, manje tacha vikas karana nahi. For example, globalization had actually destroyed our independent rural economic system. Ji bara balutedari, atha alutedari ji hoti. Which was an independent system.
System hoti, ecosystem hoti.
We have totally destroyed that. And now we are asking for skill upliftment. Blacksmith's son is not adopted in a Indian in a modern metallurgic system, so his skill has been washed out. आणि आपण त्याला इंग्रजी बोलायला शिकवतोय skill साठी.
थोडा गंभीर आणि फारच मोठा विषय, त्याच्यासाठी एक ह्यांना घ्यावा लागेल कॉन्फरन्स. परंतु मी तुमचं उत्तर देतो थोडक्यात, मग हा देईलच. हाऊ डू यू, कुणाला मराठी येत नाही असं कोड आहे, हातवरती करा. मराठी माणसाच्या बाजूला बसा. माझं उत्तर असं याला, एक तर तुम्हाला सांगतो की तो परत बजवड आहे, बॉटम ऑफ पिरॅमिड वगैरे. यू टेक एनी सेगमेंट ऑफ द एनी सेगमेंट इन्क्लुडिंग फिनान्शियल सेक्टर, द मार्केट शेअर ऑफ रूरल इंडिया इज मोर दॅन अर्बन इंडिया, इट इज ऑलरेडी चेंज. हा पहिला याचं उत्तर आहे तुम्हाला. कुठलंही घ्या, इन्क्लुडिंग फिनान्शियल सेक्टर म्हणजे आत्तापर्यंत 83% महिलांचं अकाउंट नव्हतं, तरी सुद्धा फिनान्शियल सेक्टर इज मोर इन रूरल इंडिया दॅन अर्बन इंडिया. ऑल थँक्स टू नरेंद्र मोदीजी, ती अकाउंट उघडली गेली आता 17-18 कोटी. हा एक विषय झाला. दुसरा तुमचं बलुतेदार हे आहे, हा बदलला आहे फक्त. आता बलुतेदार कोण आहे माहिती आहे का तुम्हाला? आता तिथे मॅकॅनिक आहे तो बलुतेदार आहे, कारण मोटरसायकल आली, सायकल गेली. आता तिथे अशा टाईपचे बलुतेदार आलेले आहे, आणि बार्टर सिस्टीम पण संपली, त्याची आत्ता आवश्यकता नाही. आणि तीन, मी जर आता माझ्या मुलीला म्हटलं नाही नाही मी तर एकदम रुरलवाला आहे, तुला मी काय कॅडबरी वगैरे देणार नाही, टॉफी देणार, बॉइल्ड कँडी देणार, ती घेणार आहे का? नाही घेणार. तर यू हॅव टू गो विथ द वर्ल्ड, त्याला तुम्हाला थांबवता येत नसतं. त्यामुळे तिथे ह्या गोष्टी पोचणार आहेत. ऑल थँक्स टू कम्युनिकेशन. दूरदर्शन इज रिचिंग टू 92% पॉप्युलेशन ऑफ इंडिया. सॅटेलाइट टीव्ही इज रिचिंग टू 55% पॉप्युलेशन ऑफ इंडिया. अँड द बिगेस्ट रेव्होल्युशन विच हॅज हॅपन्ड इन दिस कंट्री इज DTH, प्रत्येक घरावर छत्री. नाव द कॉस्ट ऑफ दॅट DTH से 1000 रुपीज, 5000 कलर टेलिव्हिजन आणि 2300 रुपयाचे ते वरचं डबडं, कितीतरी तुम्हाला घरातलं भारतातली घरं दाखवतो, त्यांच्या घरातल्या भांड्याची कॉस्ट कमी आहे त्याच्यापेक्षा. त्यामुळे ज्या गोष्टी, जसं ह्यांनी सांगितलं ना मगाशी टेबलावरती आपल्याकडे सॅनिटेशन आणि सेक्स बोलत नव्हते, हे सगळं बदललं बिकॉज द कम्युनिकेशन प्रत्येक घरापर्यंत पोहोचलेलं आहे. अँड एंटरटेनमेंट इज इक्वली इम्पॉर्टंट इन दिस वर्ल्ड. त्यामुळे हे आता थांबवता येणार नाही. हे कधी होईल माहिती आहे का? आता अमेरिकेतला माणूस इकडनं बघून इकडं सोडायला लागलाय, आपल्याला आता पबमध्ये जायचंय खाली, तर थोडा वेळ लागणार आहे तिथे परत यायला. आपल्याला परत ते बारा बोलते तर येणार. चोळीचे आता घालायला लागले बघा, काय काय बायका चोळीचं ब्लाऊज घालायला लागल्या, तर हे बदलणार आहे.
आय होप यू बीन.
मोठा विषय आहे, ऑफिसला या, तुम्हाला सगळं समजून सांगेन.
Okay, any other question, please? Yes, sir. A good answer.
She's coming to you with a mic.
Yeah. Yeah, social enterprising मध्ये मी गेले 10 वर्ष काम करतोय. ग्रामीण भागामध्ये मी अनेक खेडेगावी हिंडलो आहे, विशेषतः नांदेड जिल्हा. माझं स्वतःच एक असं कन्क्लुजन आहे की खेड्यात जा, शहरात जा किंवा वस्त्यात जा, झोपडपट्ट्यात, प्रॉब्लेम एकच आहे, हाताने काम करायला कुणाला नको आहे. प्रत्येक जण हाताने काम करायच्यापासून बाजूला आहे, आणि त्यामुळे या संदर्भामध्ये नेमकं काय केलं पाहिजे की जेणेकरून या शाळांच्या मधनं 8वी 9वी 10वीपासनं, 8वीपासून मी तर म्हणेन ही हाताने काम करायची सवय परकोलेट होईल तेव्हाच हा भारत खऱ्या अर्थाने मोठा होईल. त्याकरता आपलं ऑब्झर्वेशन किंवा मार्गदर्शन.
मार्गदर्शन नाही, ऑब्झर्वेशन सांगतो तुम्हाला. एक लक्षात घ्यावं लागणार आहे आपल्याला, दोष देणं हे सगळ्यात सोपी गोष्ट आहे. आपला देश 128 कोटीचा आहे, त्यामुळे 128 कोटी इश्यू आहेत, पण मोठे इश्यू आहेत. आपला काही न्यूझीलंड नाही ना 47 लाखाचा देश आणि त्याच्या याच्यावरती इथे इंग्लिशमध्ये येऊन झाडायचं काहीतरी सगळ्या समाजाला काहीतरी नो वेळ लागणार आहे. वी आर नॉट अ डेव्हलप्ड कंट्री, वी आर अ डेव्हलपिंग कंट्री. तर त्याच्या दोषासहितच आपल्याला पुढे जावं लागणार आहे. हा पहिला भाग. आळस हो, गावात निश्चित आळस आहे आणि त्याचं मी बाजू घेत नाही, पण पुढचं वाक्य फार महत्त्वाचं आहे आणि हे सर्वांसाठी आहे. द रुरल पीपल इज बीन रॉयली चीटेड फॉर लास्ट 67 इयर्स अँड वी ऑल आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दॅट. आणि मग आता म्हणायचं नाही तरी सगळं व्यवस्थित व्हायला पाहिजे. अहो तुम्ही अगरबत्ती घ्या का, सोनं घ्या का, शेण घ्या का, काय पण घ्या, ही इज बीन चीटेड रॉयली. मग काय झालं, त्याचा बिलीव कम्प्लीट गेलेला आहे त्याचा तुमच्यावर. तुम्ही किती चांगलं करायला येतात, ही इज नॉट बॉदर्ड. सो द अँसर टू दॅट इज कन्सिस्टन्सी, कन्सिस्टन्सी अँड कन्सिस्टन्सी. आणि ते पे करतच, 100% पे करतो. ह्याला माहिती ह्याला किती त्रास झाला होता. मी त्याला पहिल्या दिवसापासून फॉलो करतोय, त्याचे 2-4 इंटरव्ह्यू घेतले मी, पण ती कन्सिस्टन्सी ठेवली त्यांनी. हे त्यांचाही सेम अनुभव असेल. कुठलाही तुम्ही सोशल एंटरप्रेनर घ्या, त्याला एकच उत्तर आहे, कन्सिस्टन्सी. आणि त्याच्यात थोडंसं इनोव्हेशन करतो आम्ही प्रत्येक वेळेला, पैसे मिळाले पाहिजेत म्हणून. तर हे केलं पाहिजे. दोष देऊन साहेब काहीच होणार नाही, आपल्याला त्याच्यात उत्तर शोधायला लागणार आहे. नाही तर मग आपल्या सोशलवाल्यांना कामच काय राहणार, सगळंच भारी झालं, आपल्याला काम काय, आम्हाला इकडे हे करावंच लागणार नाही तुम्हाला, कशाला असं काही काहीच करावं लागणार नाही सगळं. त्यामुळे उत्तर शोधूयात आपण, आणि उत्तर आहे लॉट ऑफ अनसंग हिरोज इन दिस कंट्री, बिलीव मी, अँड दे आर द बॅकबोन ऑफ दिस कंट्री, दे आर रनिंग दिस कंट्री.
थँक्यू सो मच. एनी अदर क्वेश्चन प्लीज. ओके, I think with this I would like to formally thank each one of you.
Thank
given
you.
A very different perspective, a different flavor to this session, and I think we need a change of flavor as we move into the situation. Appreciate the time and appreciate
thank
the audience.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Pradeep Bhargava, Mr. Rajiv Kher, Mr. Amol Shafikar, Mr. Pramod, Pradeep Lokhande and Prashant Kirtane.